Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Feyruz and this is my Eclectic book diary. So in these videos I will mainly share things about books and things that I've read, my thoughts about them, my TBRs and my wish lists and things like that, all to do with books and bookish stuff. So yeah, so I hope you enjoy and let's get started. So for today's video I am going to share what I have read this past month, including my rereads and my new reads, so all the books that I have read. And this whole thing will be sectioned into books that I haven't read before, and we have like my rereads, and which include kind of my like the regular rereads and also my German reads, because technically my German reads are sort of a reread, but since they are in German and it's kind of a little bit harder for me to follow up with like the German language, so I'm still considering them like somewhere in between. They are technically a reread. For the time being I'm choosing to only like read books in German that I've already read previously in English or something like that, so I get to enjoy the story overall and still be learning kind of new words, and I don't have to struggle that much with like understanding things. So yeah, I'm gonna start with the new books that I've read and then we will continue to my rereads and German reads for the second section of this video. Let's start first with the first book that I've read for this whole month, and that was The Lady of the Lake from the Witcher series. So the Witcher series is written by Andrzej Sapkowski and I've quite enjoyed the series, even though I have my issues with some things in that series. It's not completely perfect, but it is, it was and it still is very enjoyable for me to read it, even though I have a little bit of a problem accepting some ideas reflected in that series. We see certain things in the books that are considered as, I believe, that could be a male gaze situation. It's not easy to talk about that subject without like ruffling some feathers, but I understand why someone would feel that way, because I did feel a little bit uncomfortable with some certain scenes, but I also don't think it's that vicious, if that makes any sense. I don't know, maybe this is an unpopular opinion, maybe it is, I have no idea, but I still feel it was a great story overall. Honestly, it didn't bother me to the point that I like couldn't read anymore or couldn't enjoy the story. I still like, I was like, oh, okay, next. That's the whole thing that happened in my head. It's just that it's worth mentioning whether you actually feel strongly like about this subject and you feel like you can't read and you feel like it's kind of offensive. You're allowed to do that. It's your choice and your mind and your feelings that are involved in this, so of course. And I totally understand as well if you didn't feel anything at all that has to do with like the male gaze situation. I don't know, I could look past that in other aspects, because there are also a lot of very very strong female characters in this like whole series, so I don't think that it was necessarily vicious. I don't know. I'm talking too much about the first book and I need to continue so this wouldn't be a million years long. So yeah, nonetheless, I did enjoy how this whole series wrapped up. I still managed to read another book from the same series for the first time, and that was Season of Storms. So that was my second read actually for this month. And that was not necessarily the last book of the series, because as I said, the last book is The Lady of the Lake. Season of Storms is more of a prequel to this whole like thing, or it's kind of a short-ish story that happens before all of the main like five books. It's very impactful, and I felt like it is really a well-written book. It was published as the last book, but it's not the last book of the series. It's actually pretty much preferable if you can read it before you start reading the Blood of Elves, which is the first book of the main series. But I would recommend to read The Last Wish before. I feel like The Last Wish, and then Season of Storms, and then Sword of Destiny, and then you will be set to go. Anyway, Season of Storms on its own, it's kind of a solid, good book, but it does have some like weaknesses involving the fact that that book was published the last one, and it is a prequel, so you always have things that will be like kind of redundant, because you already know what's gonna happen at the end of the book. Of course, that's in case you read the main Witcher Saga novels before you read Season of Storms. If you read Season of Storms before you begin with this whole journey, I think you might enjoy Season of Storms a lot more, but sometimes I like the idea of like experiencing the books as the way they were published, not as necessarily reorder them in a different way. Sometimes it's nice, but for the first time I read a book series or something like that, I'd like to enjoy the feeling of just like reading them in the way they were published. But still, it could be beneficial if you want to fully enjoy the glory of Season of Storms. I think you might enjoy reading it before you go with the actual like saga. But it's up to you. For me, I'm with the rereads, I actually did that, but for the first read I did like read it at last, and still I managed to enjoy it a lot, because I am aware of the fact that that is like the risk to take when you decide to read a prequel last thing rather than to read it the first as a first book. I don't know. It's always a tricky thing, those prequel things. Nonetheless, I really enjoyed the book. So the third book that I read this month would be The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue, which is written by V.E. Schwab, or Victoria Schwab. I don't know how I feel about this. Actually, more accurately, I should say I listened to the audiobook of this of this book. This is one of the rare occasions where I listen to the audiobook without actually like following along with the physical copy or like the regular book. And I don't think that I enjoy that much. My preference lately has been to have the audiobook with the actual like physical book and just like follow along, at least for a part of the book, not necessarily all of the book, because I still enjoy to read by myself and not like to listen to the audiobook while I'm reading. It's still very enjoyable, I would say, to also listen to the audiobook, but I still prefer to actually just follow along with the audiobook. It's kind of a very interesting mood. It gets you right into like the core of the story, I feel. But nonetheless, I did only listen to the audiobook for this case. For this book, it all begins in the 17th century or the 18th century. Something of that realm, I'm not quite sure, I forgot. The story begins in France in, as I said, the 17th or 18th century. So Addie, or Adeline, she kind of makes a deal with the darkness or the devil, whatever you want to call it, to have immortal life. But the trick is, or the catch, so to speak, is that from that moment on, even though she is like she can't die, everybody that meets her will immediately forget her. If she passes through a door, or if they pass through a door, it's finished. They forget about her, they forget that they met her, and she has to start all over again, if that makes any sense. And she lives her life on that way, and there is a certain dynamic between her and the darkness. Of course, there is a character that she will meet that will not forget about her, but that's a whole nother story on its own. Anyway, we see the hardship, we see the feelings that, and the problems that she goes through, and you just feel for her, of course. The way the writer managed to actually like express emotions are very powerful, to say the least, and it's kind of scary to think about it. To be remembered is something that is, especially by people you know or people you love, of course, it's a wonderful feeling. It's hard to think that people would forget about you, and especially if they will like if everyone you knew forgets about you. It's just, it's devastating. I can't even imagine. So anyway, you see those hardships, and you see how she handles her new life for years and years and years and years. So yeah, I believe it's a good story. I liked the details and the way I felt. Like, I started to question a lot of things after I finished the book. But I have to say that the ending of the book, I wouldn't say I hated it, but there is like the last thing that happens in the book. It's just a little bit redundant. Like, it felt like, I know, I'm smart enough, I can figure this out. I don't need to be like to be told this. I already know that this is what would happen. I don't want to say anything that would spoil the whole entire book, but anyway, I guess I was conflicted about the end of that book. Nonetheless, I enjoyed the journey. I don't think I have read a book this month that I completely disliked or I didn't like. Most of the books, I would say, or all of them, I already enjoyed, or generally speaking, I enjoyed well enough. So let's move to the fourth book that I've read for this month, and that will be The Midnight Library by Matt Haig, I believe. So it is a story about a woman in her mid-30s. Her name is Nora, and she finds herself in this library that is actually kind of a doorway to something else, let's say. But through this library, she actually gets the chance, or she has a chance, to undo whatever regrets she had in her past life. And she has a choice to do things differently. Generally speaking, those things may lead to a lot more than she thinks. Like, it's not just, okay, we erased this and now everything goes smoothly. We see through this book about the idea of, like, how our choices affect our life and the life of people around us, not just ourselves. I have to say, in the beginning of the book, it's kind of triggery and it's a little bit angsty, to be honest, like just the beginning. Anyway, I did end up enjoying the story overall, even though sometimes I felt a little bit bored. I don't know why, just like things started to get a little bit redundant. The main like concept of the story is the same, so it's just there are things that didn't feel, or moments, not necessarily all the book, but there were moments that I didn't feel like I'm completely enjoying the books. On the other hand, there were moments that I kind of like teared up and things like that. I was completely emotional about them. So there are certain things that I am greatly, greatly appreciative of, and yeah, in a general term, it was a good book to read. It leaves you with kind of a sweet taste when you finish. Anyway, the fifth book that I am currently still reading, actually, but we still have a couple of days to the end of this month, so I'm pretty sure I will be finishing this before February. And that would be this book right here. I have it in the background just because I felt like it. It's The Bone Witch by Rin Chupeco, and I am already 100 pages or more in, and it is, all of it is about like 400 pages, so I've read a quarter of it, and I'm pretty sure I will finish it before February, so I'm gonna count it for this video as well. It is a fantasy series or trilogy. This is the first book, obviously, and I don't know how I feel about this book. I know that it's still, like, still early to judge the book overall, but I have to say that I hope that the pace will pick up a little bit. I do like to get to know the characters and to get to know, like, the magic systems and, like, to have a taste of the details. I really enjoy that. I love details. But I also have to say that even though I love details, it's just sometimes it gets too much. Like, even for me, sometimes it gets too much. Maybe because I still, like, need some time to actually warm up to the characters. And maybe once I do that, things will, like, hit me and I will feel like I'm totally in. But right now I don't feel that I'm totally in. I don't know, maybe I will, because sometimes with the details, that's what happens. They sneak up on you, kind of like you feel like, oh, why I'm reading all of these details, but then all of a sudden you feel like, oh yeah, I guess the details were very, very important, because right now I am hooked on things. So I feel that I hope that would be the case. I don't think that the writing style is very straightforward. There is some, like, beautiful details inside the writing itself. I don't know if that makes any sense. But yeah, the writer does have a great ability to describe things, from, like, the clothes to, like, the foods to the scenery, generally speaking. It has a great potential, but as I said, it's not an easy going, for me at least. It's not going that easily or that smoothly. Hopefully that will change. Anyway, those were my new reads for the month of January. I have other 5 books that I am reading for the second time, or some cases third times. Those will be my rereads and my German reads. Actually, all of my rereads, whether they are in German or in English, are about the Witcher series. So this is why I didn't want to, like, mention them right at the beginning, because it's just simply I'm rereading the Witcher series in two languages. That's it. Like, so I have reread The Last Wish and Sword of Destiny as, like, my regular rereads, and I've also read them in German, and they are called Der letzte Wunsch as The Last Wish, Zeit des Sturms as Season of Storms, and Das Schwert der Vorsehung, which is Sword of Destiny. So these are the German reads, and as I said before, I liked The Witcher series and I want to reread it. Yeah, I don't know what to say about that. I enjoyed it. I am listening to the audiobooks alongside with, like, the, like, general reads. The audiobooks are amazing, especially with, like, the English version, which is narrated by Peter Kenny. It's honestly very, very, very good. I highly recommend it if you want to actually experience something very cool. I think the audiobooks of the Witcher series are amazing. Even the German edition is also very, very cool. Like, I think they are very, very cool as well. I think the German narrator, Oliver Zipek, but I could be wrong. I'm pretty sure about his last name, but I'm not sure about his first name. Anyway, I will leave their names on the screen in case you want to listen to those, in case you are interested in general. So those were my general reads for the month of January. I'm pretty happy about those. I managed to read complete 9 books, and I think I will complete the 10th as well, so I'm gonna count them as 10 books for January. I'm just saying that I know I will finish The Bone Witch before February, because I'm filming this on 29th, so I still have a couple more days to go, and I know I could finish this book. So in total, 10 books. Probably in another video I will update on how I felt about The Bone Witch, but generally speaking, those were the books that I've read. It's not about the number at the end of the day. For me, it's more about the consistency, and I feel that this number represents the fact that I was consistent enough to keep on reading, and that led me to read 10 books, and that's it. It's not about the actual number, it's just about, as I said, the consistency of the whole reading journey, and I'm quite happy about that. And yeah, thank you so much for joining me for today's video. I hope you find it useful. Take care of yourself, and I hope to see you on the next one. Until then.